Discount homage, Helena and Dawson. Also, this Alien 13 directly is such that it makes you wonder why the computer controlled ship even bothered to continue if it could never be broken.
That's an order!
Aye, aye, sir.
So, this proves the captain can will still represent a significant threat throughout the rest of this movie, because reasons. Movie steals 90 point energy from the Incredibles. Villain makes classic mistake of sending his nemesis and said nemesis's helper to the same place. You can bet that any time a robot is shut down or broken, a reboot or an alternative power source will revive. All the robots manage to stack Eve and Wally next to each other, but both robots happen to be crunched into these garbage cubes at just the right spot in order to still communicate. Moe blocks the door as Ex Machina. Can't the guard robot use the same death grip ray on Eve that it's using on this other robot? The captain smartly retrieves the image of Wally and the plant so he can trick the evil robot into thinking he has it. Problem is, the captain didn't see this part of the transmission because Eve was alone when that image came up, so he shouldn't even know this exists. Having a good look at all these people that comprise the Axiom reminds me that this ship appears entirely American. Even if that's not true, I wonder how this ship handles politics. I have so many questions about this arrangement. Now the movie's stealing the ending of Titanic.
John, get ready to have some kids!
The movie makes an attempt to make these human characters matter, but these kids are in virtually no danger. They simply would have landed in the ungodly mass of humanity further down, unharmed. You may have forgotten by this point due to all the adventure and action that has occurred since we last really saw him. Wally can barely move because a motherboard inside him is damaged, but I guess the power of robe owners can give you strength in certain situations. The movie will now reinforce the lie that just because you really want to win, you can do that, despite all obstacles, including the fact that you haven't used your muscles since you were born.
10 seconds to hyperjump.
The ship decides it can go to hyperjump 10 seconds after a plane gets inserted into a thing. Doesn't need to worry about safety, and these assholes are mildly inconvenienced when the ship blasts into hyperspace. They're not even buckled in or anything.
Wally?
Wally amnesia is, of course, separate, but it's no different from the movie that makes you think the main character got hyperjump, and that's the war is on her hand, dramatically appears on the edge of a cliff. Of course, Wally is going to remember. This is Disney, not Paul Schrader. Tiny electrical sparkles somewhere during Wally's memory loss, because that's how electronics work. Maybe instantly kills the only point of pass with whatever the hell's in that cup. When Wally appears for a mini end credit sequence, it changes the Pixar lamp cycle. Replacing it with a CFO ball to be more environmentally friendly. But when Pixar returns next year with Toy Story 3, that asshole has his old environmentally waste program back in.
Because I choose not to run!
Bra bomb, better work, nerdlinger.
The sun's energizing powers are replenishing my strength. Closer.
Closer? Oh, God, yes.
Can you read my mind?
For the last time, I'm pretty sure what's killing the crops is this Brondo stuff.
There you see me, sitting there across the way. She don't got a lot to say, but there's something about her.
You keep trying to pick a fight, but I'm still just happy you're alive.
Don't chase me, bro! Don't chase me!
Is a butt that farts horror. This is the story of a cat who lives with a young woman in a trailer park not too many years from now. The young woman is named Zoe Ash, and her cat smells like a dumpster behind a seafood restaurant on a hot summer day. One day, a little hologram man tells Zoe that some bad men are coming to kill her. These men can do magic using technology because it is the future and such things are possible. Zoe and her smelly cat must travel to a strange land called Utah, in which many people are dying in exotic and gruesome ways. Now, I don't want to spoil too much of the story, so let's just say that things only get weirder from there. Will Zoe find a way to save mankind from itself? And will she do it in time to be back at work for her Monday morning shift at the cafe? Or will both Zoe and her cat be horribly murdered by cyborgs? You will have to buy this book to find out. Futuristic Violence and Fancy Suits, a novel by New York Times best-selling author David Wong. You can find it wherever books like this are sold, or just go to futuristicviolence.com and order it that way. It's even available as an audiobook, if you think reading is stupid. The book has been called subtly brilliant by Publishers Weekly, and Booklist calls it explosive, smart, and witty.
futuristic violence and fancy suits is an adventure suitable for all ages.